Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome to today's session. Today's session is on decision trees. Now you might have heard about decision trees, and today's session will give you a little more brief or depth understanding about decision tree as a tool for decision making. Now this is coming in operations research under decision theory. Okay. Now I'll give you a small hypothetical example which gives you a feeling, gives you an understanding as how powerful is decision tree. Now, just imagine you are in a multinational company that is selling, that's a bank that provides loans. Okay. Now, you're supposed to come out with an advertisement, but you don't know as to which segment you should target, like for which segment you should, which segment would be the one, or which category of people would be taking this particular loan. So what you do is you are trying to make an analysis. So you collected some data to understand who should be your target audience. So you understand that basically males are the people who take loans. Okay. So for this you are studying about males pattern. They understand that below 20 years of age, only 10% of male take loans. Okay. So and below, in between 20 to 40 years of age, 70% of males take loans, and more greater than 40 years of age, only 20% of male take loans. Okay. Now further, when you studied in depth, you understood in that second category of 20 to 40 years of age, where there were 70%, where when the people are married and having no kids, only 10% take loans. But when they are married and they have kids, 60% of the people take loans. When more than 40 years of age, when they are married and have no kids, only 10% take loans. More than 40 years of age, where married and kids, close to another 10% take loans. So with this particular analysis, you understand one thing. The major chunk of people is with married and having kids of age range 20 to 40 years. So you're supposed to target them. So that is where your segment lies. And how did you come to this particular conclusion? You were drawing a tree kind of figure as what is being depicted in the screens right now. So coming out stage by stage and deciphering the data and coming to a decision with logical reasoning is known as decision tree. Now, decision tree is a graphical analysis of a decision making process. Just now we understood how we did this particular analysis in a graphical method. It is a usual construct for visualizing a firm's business decision and setting out all logical possibilities associated with it. So based on the decision tree, you will be able to take very good decisions for your problems that is coming out in your business scenarios. So what are the different components of a business, of a decision tree? You have basically two components or three components in a decision tree. The first one is a decision node, which is depicted using a square, and you have a chance node, which is depicted using a circle. You have events at the end, and which is depicted using straight lines. So these are the different components of a decision tree. Now we will check in depth about decision tree with this particular basics that we have got. We will try to analyze a problem. The question given to us is: a glass factory specializing in crystal is experiencing a potential backlog, and the firm's management is considering three courses of action: arrange for subcontracting, construct new facility, or do nothing. The correct choice depends largely upon demand, which may be low, medium, or high. Show this decision by form of a decision tree and indicate the most preferred decision and its corresponding expected value. Now, I'll just explain as what the question is speaking about. We have a glass factory that is specializing in crystal manufacturing. Now there is a substantial backlog. Backlog means they are not able to meet the demand.
They are in short of demand, in short of production. So what they are trying is, they are trying to outsource to somebody, or that is subcontracting, or they are thinking of building a new project, a new plant, or do nothing. So it will basically depend on the demand. The demand may be low, medium or high. Depending upon the demand, they have to choose any one of them. That is, S1 is the arrange subcontracting, S2 is construct new facility, and S3 is do nothing. So which one should they choose? Whether it is S1, S2, S3, you have to do this with the help of a decision tree. Now they are already given us the payoff table. Now since the payoff table is given, things are much more easier for us. So now let us find out the expected monetary value. Expected monetary value. Now, in order to do the decision tree, we first of all find out the expected monetary value. Now, expected monetary value is a very simple process. You will first of all do it in column wise. So for S1, S2 and S3, you will be finding the EMVs. So how to do this is 0.1 into 10 plus 0.5 into 50 plus 0.4 into 50. So this is what has been depicted here. Now similarly for the strategy S2, you will take 0.1 into minus 20, 0.1 into minus 20, 0.5 into 60 plus 0.4 into 100. So you will get 68. Similarly for S3, 0.1 into 150, 0.5 into 20 and 0.4 into 200. So you will get an answer. Now what you are supposed to do is, you have got three different answers now: 46, 68 and 75. Out of this, you have to find the maximum value. Now the maximum value here is 75. So you select the maximum value. Now this is the expected monetary value. Now the question here is to find out the decision tree, or to draw the decision tree. Now since this is ready made for us, and you have made the EMV solution, now we'll think of creating a decision tree. So decision tree has basically three different attributes. One is the decision node, then is the chance node, and then the events. Now decision node is depicted using a square, the chance node is depicted using a circle, and events are written at the end. Now here you can depict the decision tree like this. The decision node, you can write any value. It is not very important that you should write D, you can write A, B, anything. It is immaterial. Now then what happens, you have three different methods. You have you can give it for subcontracting. The strategy two is you have to take overtime, or you can construct the facility. Now what happens is, for all the EMV values you write down here and you add them. When you add them, you get a value. When you add all these, again you do all this, you calculate, you add, you get 68. The same thing whatever we did for the EMV, you just pictorially represent them. So as a solution, what happens is, you have to find the maximum one. The maximum that is over here is 75. So as per the decision tree analysis, the S3 strategy will be selected. So once again, I would just brief out what happens is, we find out the EMV of expected monetary value for that particular question, and then you try to draw it. You draw, you have a decision node, you have a chance node, and you have the events. So you have the decision node drawn there. Then you have the three different alternatives, and then that you write here. Then you have the chance. Then you have the chance node. You can have three chances, and then you write down the different events. What are the different events? The EMVs you have to write down in numbers, and finally you take the number which has the maximum value. The maximum value is 75. So that is coming under S3. So as per the decision tree analysis, the strategy 3, that is constructing a facility, is being selected. Okay, so thanks for watching my webinar.